Guys, oh my goodness. I gotta tell you something. I'm addicted. I can't get over it. I can't. No. We need to open more Modern Masters booster box. 2017, guys. It's so good. It's so addicting. But please watch my previous episode down in the description below and up here. Right there. And make sure guys check my previous video, and there's a giveaway that I'm doing that hopefully guys you can participate on it. And make sure you click on the like button and subscribe and comment down below for more information. Thank you so much guys. Let's do this. Let's get those tarmos. Hello again guys. So as requested by a subscriber, he wanted me to talk, so I'll actually talk, and I want to make some comments too regarding the comments and uncommons, like how useful they are in drafting. 'Cause to be honest, to save money, you really don't have to buy a box. It's just more of a drafting if you want to just get the value. But if you're after for just a single, just I suggest you just buy the single instead of like getting the packs, getting the box, or but if you're a drafter, you love drafting, Modern Masters has always been amazing in draft. From 2013 until the 17 right now, I'm amazed how Wizards, able to combine each piece in each interaction with the cards that they actually put in the set. So thank you, Wizards. You're amazing. You're good. So we're gonna open the this box, and we're gonna go in and talk about a lot of things inside. Okay, so we have our guest star right here, Saitama. Hi. Hi. Hello. All right, let's do this. I hope it's not gonna be a lengthy video because I know you guys want it to be a little bit short. So I'm gonna make it as quick as possible. Hopefully we get those good shenanigans right here. First pack. All right. Too expensive. Burning tree. This is has always been a staple in standard before, and now still being used in modern. Really good in ramping, like a free spell. Is really good for fixing your mana if you have multiples. And like I said, green, red, white, if you watch my previous video, they're really good in drafting right now. So if you come across those cards, tokens, please make sure you include the Sylvan Ranger for mana fixing. One of the best easy removal, like one turn one. Come on, you pay only one for only one attacking creature. That's awesome. Augur Bolas, it's like a really good cantrip. What do you call it again? The Peer Through Depths. Oh my god! Actually last night I was in a draft. This card killed me. This token right here. Like the conspire, let me adjust the. Ooh, this is hard. All right, so the conspire, guys. If you're not familiar with the conspire, so you may tap two creatures that share the same color as this. Like for example, you have red, you have green. You can tap two creatures like goblins and whatever tokens you have, and you can copy this spell, so you're actually casting it twice, right? If I'm wrong, just correct me in the comments below. But this is how what happened last night. So there's a goblin, I forgot what's his name. Wart something. It's a 3/3, 5/5 to play. I think green red goblin. That when it comes into play, you get two goblin tokens. So it has to inspire. So each spell that you play has conspire. So imagine, I didn't know either, even that in one spell you can actually have two conspires. Like it stacks. Like for example, like the ward gives this conspire, and this adds to the conspire itself, so you can actually play this multiple times. So I asked the judge, like, is that really, you know, possible? Like I thought that a spell, an existing ability can't be overlapped. So I don't know, maybe I was wrong. But yeah, this is actually a really good card. You imagine like three, and then you can create like, I don't know, like four red green giant. That's crazy. And this one too, it's like a good combination. I don't know, for some reason. Modern Rain, Unflinching Courage. Oh my goodness. All right, Death Shadow. Always been a great card. Online right now, it's being dominated by Death Shadow. So if you're into Modern and you want a really good deck, but quite expensive, but Death Shadow is really good. I mean, you gotta love that card. And this card, oh my goodness. I hate this card, but I love it at the same time. It's really good. It's like, come on, like you have a 4-4, although it's 6 to play, but then in late game, it's really good against the enemy or the opponent because it just, it brings back the, you know, the permanent, and plus he discards. What if it's like a token, you know? The opponent has a token, and then you just like bounce it off and your opponent discards at the same time. So it's kind of like crazy, right? So that was our first pack. It's been 5 minutes already, I'm sorry guys. Alright, I'll try to speed it up. I'm just excited to open Modern Master and talk about it. Really good early game card. Fisher is good to bounce your token producing creatures, like, you know, the core golem producing thing. So yeah, this one is really good. Ironwood is good for producing token. Dragonfather, come on, this is awesome. Momentary blink, oh my goodness, like all your producing token creatures just blink it out and come back again, and also the gain 4 life. Oh my goodness, this actually won me a lot of games last night. Tandem, if you're a control, definitely use this. Put in the any flyer and stuff, and you have control. Dang, keep drawing. Always been good before. No, I didn't really see this in play. Mana fixing. This one is, come on, 3. And when it dies, you get 3 again. That's so good. Oh, this is the one I'm talking about earlier. Work, the freaking goblin shaman. So I hate it. So each red and green instant sorcery spell you cast has conspire. So yeah, that's what I was asking earlier. Like, imagine this card has another conspire. So I don't know, guys. Correct me if I'm wrong. If there's a judge there watching, or if ever, please put your comments down below. I'm not really sure. Because we actually read the ruling on this. It actually gives conspire to another conspire. So I'm confused. So yeah, it's a good card. If that actually works, that's crazy. Come on, you can just tap your creatures and boom, you get like entreat the angels kind of thing, you know, with haste. That's crazy. Rewind, annoying. Oh, this is the one that killed me, like, you know, like the last minute. I was like down to one and my opponent was like, I don't know, like five or something, and he's dead next turn, but then he got this. I was like, ah, why? Call, token producing, real good. Explorer. I don't know how many times this thing saved me. Like, I'm really out of lands and just keeps like, you know, drawing my hand. I love it. Removal, really good in draft. This one too is, dang, I hate this. I really hate this. The overload is cheap, and plus you know, you attack with all your creatures, like your tokens, I'm telling you, and put this overload, boom, so good. Yeah. Ugh, this card. You know, this card's so good, but it's so, I don't know, the value is low. If you're a control deck, I mean, it's really nice. the hell? Alright. Come on. Give some value here. Saitama, give us your one punch. Kill it. Storm. I remember I was telling you guys about the combo in this one. The Beetle and the other vampire. Oh my god, this, if you guys get across this, just grab it. I count this as a removal, tap the creature, come on. And it's actually good too. Oh, it is the Beetle, the one I'm telling you about. See, like, you sack it, you put plus one this one, then boom. Flash her. Oh, I love this card. I mean, this won me a lot of games earlier. Like, seriously, they kind of bounce my tokens or whatever, they're trying to kill it. Populate, boom, indestructible. More tokens. Especially the golem, oh. They'll be so annoyed. This one is good removal. Ah, Fireclasm classic. Love it. Burial Rites, I don't know. I barely see any use for it in draft, but sure. If you have Gifts and Given. Burden Catacombs! Our first special in. Definitely separated here. Good stuff. And Blood Rush. Come on. If some new players are not familiar about Blood Rush, this is not a spell, okay? So you can't counter it. Make sure you don't make that mistake, guys. Okay? There's a lot of people that do that, so. 11 minutes, I'm so sorry. Alright. No. Aggro? Good. Oh, this is the vampire I was talking earlier. So you sack it, the other vampire, you gain life, the opponent loses life, and the beetle gains 1 plus 1 plus 1. So, right? So good. This card sucks here. I don't know. Madcap, come on. It's really good. If this is only like lower spell, I mean lower in casting, probably like, I don't know, two core or less, that would be so good. You have a flyer, like Lingering Souls. I love this card. Come on, want to play, populate, like produce more token. If you have the ooze, like 8/8, whatever, put one token for one, it's crazy. Terminate! Separate that, I love Terminate. Good blocker. Dapper Matrix, goodbye, artifacts. Basilisk Collar, an art. Man, this is, you know what, to be honest, like, this really rose up. Before it was, people ignored this card, but now it's like being recognized. So, which is really, has really been good. I mean, Basilisk Collar, come on. And equip that to, I don't know, like, Walking Ballista. It's crazy. So Damping Matrix. It's like your Limbala. Limbala artifact. Not really. Good removal. Ooh, Soul Sisters. I'm just taking note of what, you know, what is a really good draft. This card. Shroud, come on. Flyer. 0/8. Look at how fat that is. It's okay. Oh, I thought it was something mythic. Sphinx. Back in standard. Or Jessica Control. This is about the other one is produced Golem, but I like the fort to play plus one plus one Golem and plus a Spicer. That is spicy. And we got a Golem. Golem. Is it Golem or Golem? I don't know. Tell me, guys. Good ramp. Ugh. This is good removal, but it's like sorcery. I'm not sure. You guys into it? Guilford is okay. Blood Rush. Oh, I love this card, I swear. Look at that. Denial, yeah. Right. Boom. Oh my god. Kind of. I use this too for a token, but if you have other options better than this, then just put it. But if you have no other ones that you draft and you have this, just put it in. You know, that's what she said, but yeah, just put it in. Put it in! Magma Jet. What else can I say? Awesome removal in Dimir. Hate it though. And this is a really it's like your pumping. This is really good. Draw. Not really. Compulsive research, river control, but come on. Wants to play control in draft. Come on, it's like being a douchebag, but sure, if you're into control, this is good. The only draw spell off green, this is nice. Stoic Angel. I keep getting that. Earlier I got that in draft too, it's crazy. Like, I didn't even use it. It's like useless. Not really useless, but... it's like, what do you call it again? Zuran? Oh, no. Winter Orb, right? From beta. This one, it's a good removal. Or, you know, whatever. Just flyer and just blink back. Well, not blink back, but return to hand. If it's a token, just put it back. Could be a removal. -4. Good to blink. If your opponent's like full of 1/1 creatures, like, I don't know, like, there you go, full of 1/1 creatures with just tokens, that's the go-to card. Thunderous Wrath, it's good though. Oops. Ooh, this is one of the good ones. Come on, regenerate. It's like a totally immortal golem. Crackling part. Cackling, sorry. It's not crackling. Cackling. Ooh, Dimir horror. You know, Gilgates are good, but Tap Lance is kind of like really. It's good for mana fixing, sure. But I wouldn't really like totally advise it, but. Sure, go ahead, but I prefer like basics, just like get your Sylvan Ranger for search. Flicker Wisp, Dead and Taxes, bah, Scavenging Ooze. Ooh, Inquisition, foil. Ah, yeah. How much is this, like 25, 20? I mean, the Rise of Eldrazi one is probably like 50 plus or so, 80, I'm not sure, forgot, but it's close to that price. Remember when Inquisition was like $5 only? Come on. Ancient Grudge, if you have so many mana, go ahead, draw a card with this. Nope. Misty Rainforest or second Fetchland. Golem. Oh, we got foil. Okay, Stoic Angel, come on. Give us Tarmogoyf. Damn it. Okay. Oracle gives you like free land, but you know. You won't always hit the lottery, Track Dusk. You know it's really nice if you have this and I mean the opponent has this or you have this and you phantasmal image it and draft. That's so funny. Sure. Look at this printing, it's like weird. It's so dark. Like it's kinda, I don't know. It's supposed to be like this. kind of dark. Okay, Domri Rod, Domri Raid. Oh, this one too is so good. You prevent damage and you populate. If you're playing like white, yeah, like I said, like white, red, green, and you have Entreat the Angels with this. Ooh, so nasty. This one too, Hookmaster. Oh, no, not that. The Fisher, the one I'm talking about is the Fisher. Good sideboard with populate. Crazy. Where is it? Where are we? Oh, one more. Boom, 6/6. Standard and Great Crash. Oh, here, the Falcon Rat. Noble. So just sack all these creatures and keep gaining Angel. Why did I put it here? Go back there. Alright, it'll be fun if you get Liliana on the Crystal Brand pack. Like, you know that Liliana. Didn't Liliana like summon Gristlebrand to, you know, for revenge for Avacyn? I'm not sure. Forgot the lore or the story on that. Ooh, is a charm. I love this card. I use it in Gorgeous Vengeance. So ransom blue. Boom. I got this early in draft and didn't even use it. It's useless, but it's good in Commander. It's good in. In some control decks. Yeah. Necromancer. I'm not even playing Storm. I did build Storm before in Paper Magic, but it's too like, you know, like solo game. Like you're playing by yourself. Oops, sorry. Ooh, this is the one to tell me about. Like a blink this guy, keep blinking and gain 4. That's annoying. Like my opponent was annoyed earlier, like, ah, you came again. Oh, Might of Old Krosa, yeah. Infect for days. Pyromancer. Boom. I really haven't seen this in Storm anymore. I don't know. Is it banned? I don't know. It's not banned, right? I'll check them later. I'm not sure. I haven't seen it really. Dino Charger. Hate it. That's so good. And this one too is if you're in control. Alright, what are we getting? Oh, sorry. Goblin Guide! Ooh, common. I hope Goblin Guide, like, the price, I hope it lowers, because, you know, ever since like Burn became so popular before, you know what, Burn was I don't know, like a less than $100 deck. But now how much is it, like 400 300? Oh, it's crazy. Like it was so cheap before, but Goblin Guy like rose up and everyone uses fetches there. So okay, ready, here we go. Boom. Ooh, our third. Yeah, third, right? Yeah, third. And we got Thunderstruck, Wrath. Third fetch. Yeah. Token. Alright, Domirod. Do not bring back your gate crash. It's one of the awful set. But it's okay. It's good in drafting, but standard, it's okay. Oh, I love this card. Sure. Goblin Assault. Abrupt Decay. Pretty good. Yeah, this is the Ooze I'm talking about. If you have enough mana to just pump it. But I'd rather play the counter one. Counter spell. It's like 5 though. Pretty expensive. Stoic Angel. discard. I think my face is familiar with the combo from back then. It's like one of the big combos before. Putrefy, really good removal. Oh, we got a Restoration Angel. And a Guild Gate. The F. Ooh, Stern Visions. I was gonna love that. It's good. Like, you know, addition to their intangible virtue. Torn Souls. Where are we at? Okay, one more. Oh! What? What? I have only two uncommons. So this are mythic. Eh? What? Oh, we got the Stern Visions. Yeah, I forgot. So. Temporal Mastery. I don't know if the deck, the unlimited turns, I forgot what it's called. It's still okay. Still good. I used to have the deck online. I guess I have a video on that one previously, like years ago. Tin Collector, really nice card. Boom. Arsakov! I mean, opposite that. Really good in draft. You guys get it across with this, just use it. Oh my gosh, it's like two packs left. What the heck? My cat. Ah! Discard. What? Kikijiki combo. Did they even use it still? This is our second to last pack. We're not even getting any. Passing Flames. Common. Ah, what the hell? What foil rare did we get? I forgot. Did we get a foil rare? It's like the last pack. We've been had. See what this is. It's the last effing pack. Bam! Saiyans! And MTG Goldfish made a deck with this. It's good. The Esper Saiyans. Is this our last pack yet? Full Arid Mesa? Yeah. Are we satisfied with this? Sure. Right? Still good. So, to make a recap, wait, this is a foil, yeah. So, got our uncommons here. Just gonna remove this. I'm just like babbling about these earlier. Tokens. Golems are expensive before. So, reviewing our mythics. Will be here. This is a mythic before, right? Another mythic. There's another mythic. That shadow. So I guess we only got three mythics? What? So these are probably the most expensive one. I didn't even see another one. Another foil rare or mythic. Yeah. Well, here, another foil rare, yeah. So we have two foil rares. So we have the Basilisk Collar. What is it? Why is this here? We have these, our fetch lands. So we got four, and I think we're just missing the Marsh Flats to complete it. But on value, these are the most valuable ones. I'm just gonna like separate them. I don't know what happened, but the camera suddenly stopped. Crap. So what I was saying is these cards are useful, sure, but they don't hold like value. They're like probably less than $1 or $2, and these are most probably less than $5. Goblin Guide, I'm not sure the price right now, but before it was the previous original version, it's like, I don't know, 30 25. That Shadow, pretty expensive. I think it was more than $10, the original one though. So this is our mythics. We only have 3 mythics. They're not even that expensive. Our most valuable are the fetch lands and the foil Ad Mesa. Basilisk Collar, I'm not sure what the price, but yeah. Alright, guys, thank you so much for watching, and please like and subscribe. Comment down below what you guys think, and please join the giveaway that I have in a previous video. Check it out, the release date of Modern Masters 2017. Make sure you join the giveaway. Hit like, subscribe, comment. That's how you win. Share the video, and thanks so much for watching. Always remember, guys, put a smile on your face. This is not a smile, but it's a heart. A heart is a smile, so that makes sense. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching.